This is Lights. You're listening to XTSR Towson Radio. Hi, this is Catie, and I'm here with Lights. How are you doing today?
I'm excellent. How are you?
I'm doing pretty well. Well, let's first talk about your brand new single, which is Timing is Everything. Can you tell us a little bit about it?
Yeah, it's kind of funny because there was no intention for that ever to be a single. It's like, you know, just one of the tracks in the record. We were all set about every one of the tracks, but Ken Galloway, the director of the video, approached us with the idea. He said, I have this idea for this video, this song in particular, and if we could do it for, you know, dirt cheap, would you want to make like a viral video for this? And I was like, well, what's there to lose, you know, let's do it, you know. And usually I come up with the treatments for my videos, the idea of them, but he had this idea and it was really cool, and so we just made it for the thing, and it turned out so well that it is like beyond what I ever expected it to be, but super fun. It was like one of the funnest videos to make because it's just no work involved. It's just doing some lifting.
Definitely. It looked really, really fun with the gym idea. So
yeah.
Do you go to the gym often or did you
I don't go to the gym at all, but yeah, it was like one of the few times I've actually been in a gym, and actually surprisingly the only times I've ever really been in a gym or when I make videos, like before the ice video, I did a lot of like Muay Thai training so that I could get some of the moves down.
Yeah.
But yeah, it's funny. It was fun to make though.
So what inspired the song?
The song is about serendipity, and that's what the video is about too. It's kind of about those fluky moments that you have in life that lead to something great, and that happens to the like everyone.
Mm-hmm.
You know, when you meet someone that you fall in love with, it's never preconceived or anything. It's always just like right place at the right time and something.
Sunset again without a hat, so in the interim.
There's rumor going around that there's a new EP coming out from you soon.
There's lots of rumors.
So can you dispel some of those rumors, let us know what's going on?
No, it's there's definitely a little project that's going to be coming for the duration of creating the new record. So we've taken a break writing and hopefully putting something out in that time.
Okay.
That involves acoustic.
Sounds really fun.
Yeah.
And you also took the time to collaborate on a music project, which was a cover of True Colors,
yeah,
with some other artists, and you were encouraging people to take a stand against bullying. So how did you get involved with that? Like, how did that get started?
Well, it was probably, I think, it started with what happened with the Manitot in British Columbia. If you're not familiar with the story, it's a young woman who took her own life because she was bullied. Tog Salter, actually one of the co-writers, producers that I've been writing with for years and working with, he's a good friend of mine, probably 10 years we've been writing together. He was really moved by her situation because of his young daughter, and so he called me and said, would you want to be involved with this project I'm putting together, you know, just getting a whole bunch of people to sing, and I don't know who's going to be on it or Obie Park or what it would be, but he's going to be a cover of True Colors. And I love Cyndi Lauper, and he's such a good friend and such a good cause. Like, no brainer, yeah, of course I'll do it. And ended up just being able to run into the studio and do my stuff on it, and the day before I left for this tour. And, you know, I started hearing more and more of the people that were going to be on it, and by the end product thought, I was like, wow, this is such a great project. It worked out really well, and I think it's been encouraging to a lot of people. And every 100% of the proceeds goes to Kids Help Phone. And it's, you know, it's a really cool project to do, and those things aren't a brainer.
Have you been surprised by like some of the people who have come forward after hearing the song and like saying it affected them in any way?
And some things, you know, it's sometimes hard to tell directly who's moved by it and what's happened, but we did see like some of the comments on the YouTube stuff. It's like people saying it helped them through. They were able to find Kids Help Phone and were able to call them and get them through some things. I mean, you can't be too open in a YouTube comment. But
so what is your favorite part about touring?
We're pretty lucky to do what we do, and it is hard and it's exhausting. It's not like all fun and games like I think a lot of people think it is, but at the end of the day, like, we're doing what we love and we're playing music for a living, and traveling from city to city, it's like a circus going around and just playing music. So that's awesome, man. And getting to meet people and hear their stories and hear how they're moved by your music, and it really encourages you to keep going, you know.
Is there one thing that you think people would be really surprised about if they got to come on tour with you and see what tour life is like?
I think a lot of people would be surprised at the amount of work that goes into putting on a great show. We always make sure that the show is like top-notch, you know, and I have such great people behind it. Like, so we always make sure that sound check goes well, so everything sounds perfect. We have an awesome lighting guy. The band is amazing. We put so much effort in trying to make the show great. And I think that it's sometimes undervalued. Sometimes when people go to a show and don't know what goes into it behind the scenes. So I wish we could make a DVD and show. It's like this clockwork in it, and it's new every night. Every night you get into the new venue, and it's like, okay, how are we going to make this work tonight, you know? And it's a new challenge every day. And it's like, it's a lot of work put in by everyone, and it's, you'll stand back and take a look at it, and you're really proud of it.
Okay, so something else that happened to you earlier this year is that you got married. So how is it being a married woman and being on tour and having to deal with that sort of lifestyle? I mean, you're with a bunch of boys all the time.
Yeah.
How is that?
I've not really had any other lifestyle, so I don't really know what to compare it to, I guess. But you take it for... take the best things out of it that you can, and one great thing with a distance relationship like that is it's reignited every time you see each other. So you do spend a lot of time apart, but you have to really trust each other, and I think if it's real love, then trust kind of comes with that, and it's just living your life, and then looking, always just waiting to the next time you can see each other, and waiting until the next time. You can't plan too far in the future, and that's another one of the things you sacrifice living a life on the road, is some, you know, a family, kids, that kind of thing, that's gonna have to wait, but you know, it's fun.
What's 2013 look like?
2013 is, well, this is the last tour before I'm gonna start working on new stuff, so I mean, with Safer, maybe a few shows here and there, it's gonna be a lot of just kind of buckling down and starting to write and getting some new stuff going and hopefully releasing said project in the time to help people over. And, you know, just hoping that a new record can connect you to, and then touring on that and starting it all over again. I'll talk to you another year and a half.